Native people, Native culture, Native knowledge. Hi, I'm Jeannie Green, bringing you award-winning Heartbeat Alaska.
Bringing you national and international Native news, this is award-winning Heartbeat Alaska, the premier Native voice in Native programming.
There's a heartbeat louder than thunder. Revolution is in the air. There's a heartbeat deep inside our mother. Are you too cool to care?
Now, with Heartbeat Alaska, here's Jeannie Green.
Hello, welcome to Heartbeat Alaska, Native news and Native entertainment. Hello and a special warm welcome to our new viewers on the East Coast. The Passamaquoddy tribe in Maine are watching Heartbeat Alaska on their reservation TV. We'll be receiving video from them soon and we'll share their tribe with you. Once again, welcome Passamaquoddy tribe in Maine. On today's program, we travel to Kwethluk, Alaska, thanks to a piece done by KYUK-TV out of Bethel. Also, we travel to Bethel for the Tundra Women's Coalition Stand Against Domestic Violence. We debut a brand new music video from Claude McKenzie of Cash Tin. Here's Gary Fife with Native News Across the Nation. I'll be back real soon, so don't go away.
This is Native News Across the Nation. I'm Gary Fife. Two bands of the Oneida Nation are at odds with each other over the future of their two tribes. An advertisement in News from Indian Country was sponsored by the Oneida Tribe of New York. It calls a move by the Oneida Tribe of Wisconsin to establish a new tribal government in its former homelands of New York and, quote, invasive action, unquote. The Wisconsin band has announced its plans to set up in New York, but the New York Oneida say the new government would compete with those who did not move from their ancestral homelands. Representatives of many indigenous peoples of the world walked out of a work session at the United Nations in late October. According to non-governmental observers, members of people such as the Native Americans, Native Canadians, Pacific Islanders, and others left the working session. They were dissatisfied with the United Nations' failure to adopt their draft of a Declaration of Rights of Indigenous Peoples around the globe. The Alaska Federation of Natives wants the federal government to pay cash compensation for the lack of Native workers on the Trans-Alaska Pipeline. AFN says the Interior Department did not hold up its part of the deal by enforcing the provisions for the hiring of Alaska Natives on the pipeline. The result, AFN President Julie Kitka says, was that Alaska Pipeline has not employed Natives in sufficient numbers nor provided training. Bureau of Land Management officials say those payments are not likely to happen. For almost 20 years, a small band of Delaware people have legally been a part of the Cherokee Nation of Oklahoma. It was a misinterpretation of the tribe's 1866 treaty that left the group's affairs being administered by the Cherokees, but now the 10,000 Delawares have a new recognition agreement with the federal government. It makes them eligible for support, services, and contracts with the government. And again, we'd like to say thank you to those of you who have been sending in your news and information. We certainly appreciate it, and we certainly love those videos. We're going to tell you how, and then I'll be right back with more Native news across the nation.
Contact Heartbeat Alaska with your news. Heartbeat Alaska, 5861 Arctic Boulevard, Unit B, Anchorage, Alaska, 99518. That's Heartbeat Alaska, 5861 Arctic Boulevard, Unit B, Anchorage, Alaska, 99518. Or give us a call at 1-907-563-7440 or fax us at 1-907-563-9309. Heartbeat Alaska, your news is our news.
Tribes who operate successful gaming enterprises are being called to a national conference to discuss the future and expansion of tribal gaming. The California Nevada Indian Gaming Association is holding its Western Indian Conference and its trade show next week in Reno, Nevada. The show will present resource workshops on subjects such as marketing, public relations, catching cheaters, and national legislation. Native peoples of Canada are getting on their own feet in the world of business these days. A recent report from Statistics Canada said 5 years ago there were about 10,000 Native entrepreneurs, but now 34 Native businesses have come into operation, and they say that number is growing. An organization called Aboriginal Business Canada is being credited with lending its support to the Indian, Inuit, and Métis peoples and their entrepreneurs. This fall, a group of Oklahoma Native veterans gave the Federal Veterans Administration an earful on behalf of themselves and other Native veterans. A half dozen Sac and Fox veterans of America's wars told the federal representatives that Native veterans' problems were often ignored. They said that Native vets are commonly routed to hospital wards treating alcoholics, even if their problems are not alcohol-related. Native veterans suffering from the effects of chemical Agent Orange used in the Vietnam War were told their problems were related to diet and lifestyle. And finally, the showdown between heavyweight boxers Mike Tyson and Evander Holyfield has been settled, with Holyfield taking the title. But in the future, a Native boxer could be challenging the champion for world boxing dominance. Sam Hampton, a Choctaw from Tallahena, Oklahoma, is currently the Intercontinental Boxing Champion, and he's ranked among the top 15 heavyweights in that boxing industry. Hampton says his next fight, scheduled in January, could prove to be the key to moving up in the boxing world. This is Native News Across the Nation. For Heartbeat Alaska, I'm Gary Fife, and now back to Jeannie.
Thank you, Gary. Efforts are now underway across Alaska so that they can receive Alaska Rural Communication Service and other channels. If they don't update their equipment, they won't have TV. Kwethluk, Alaska demonstrates how they're able to do it with the use of volunteer help.
You'd think it was rush hour in Kwethluk, the way everybody was on the move when we arrived. But the fact is, village life is very busy. Some villages have apparently been too busy to realize that soon they will not be able to receive ARCS, the state satellite TV channel, unless someone in the village has installed new equipment to convert the village satellite system to digital technology. The state has sent each village equipment to convert their satellite dishes and receivers.
The place where the ARCS satellite receivers are kept vary from village to village. Some are in the corporation stores or in the city offices. In my village here in Kwethluk, the receiver is kept at the school, upstairs in the attic, away from the kids.
Luckily for Kwethluk, Stanley Spean, who works for the village electric company, volunteered to install the new digital receiver.
About a week and a half ago, maybe 2, 3, 4 times.
Stanley says he received a video from the state about a week and a half ago explaining how to install the equipment. There were also some detailed written instructions.
And then next step, if you read the step-by-step instruction, once you understand it, it'll be easy.
The process is much like hooking up a VCR.
The first cable that I had to work was with this AC plug-in that came with a new satellite digital system. Next important one is that RFN that comes in from the satellite disk.
While you don't need an engineering degree to do this work, it does take some technical skill and attention to detail. And Stanley says he was happy to offer his time and expertise.
Without the new system, we couldn't get no state, local, national, international news. And I think it was very important that we get in the new ARCS digital system.
There's a Stanley in every village, that special someone who knows how to fix things and get them done. He says he had to watch the video several times and study the instructions carefully, but it didn't take long to get the picture.
And the next thing I had to do was I had to string up this cable, and I had to tie wrap it, and now I had to take off that old analog system.
Stan had some help climbing up on a ladder to do the work, but with a little teamwork, Kwethluk was set up to receive ARC's new digital signal in an hour and a half. Kwethluk is like many villages in Alaska, where people can hunt, skin, and cure a beaver without a second thought, and at the same time be tuned into the modern world through new technology. For the Alaska Rural Communications Service, I'm Lillian Michael.
Auntie Mary's daughter. Heartbeat Alaska, taking you home.
Just in time. Hi, I'm Ginny Green. Welcome to Heartbeat Alaska's Christmas special. Greetings from all over the state. It's that time of year again. Time to record your Christmas greetings for our fifth annual Heartbeat Alaska 1 hour Christmas special. We created this unique format, 1 hour of personal Christmas greetings for your friends and family. This year, we'll be aired Christmas Day and Eve over ARCs. And here in Anchorage, we'll be aired on Channel 7, December 22nd, KAKM. Don't miss us for this year's Christmas special.
Stay tuned for greetings from all over the state.
For 30 years, the Alaska State Council on the Arts has supported Alaskan artists and communities. This message is sponsored by the Council and the National Endowment for the Arts.
Thank you so much, Lillian Michael and KYUK-TV at Bethel for that story. Back in Bethel, the Tundra Women's Coalition are taking a stand against domestic violence. Dances are popular in rural Alaska, a way to socialize. The whole family often joins in. Recently, they danced in Bethel, Alaska for a purpose, to raise money for the Tundra Women's Coalition Shelter, a shelter for victims of domestic violence and sexual assault. Domestic violence is the leading misdemeanor on the Yukon-Kuskokwim Delta. However, statewide, statistics are overwhelming. Alaska has the highest number of rape and sexual assault cases in the nation, yet only 1 in 10 rapes are reported. The Tundra Women's Coalition held ceremonies last month and demonstrated against domestic violence. They walked through the center of Bethel. This was to help bring attention to domestic violence. It was a very cold day, and as they walked, they remembered victims who sometimes have to flee their homes in the middle of winter, without gloves or hats, and the cold these victims had to endure.
Of a week when children can walk in the dark unattended, dream of a year when no one is beaten or raped or murdered or driven insane.
The Tundra Women's Coalition provided shelter to 458 women and children last year. Governor of Alaska Tony Knowles declared October as Domestic Violence Awareness Month. And in Bethel, Alaska, they danced, they walked, and they talked domestic violence.
Anything that says that one person is better than another is dangerous. Whether it's based on my income, or my color, or my religion, or my culture, it's dangerous. When might makes right, and when power and control are part of it, That's the danger.
According to seminar speaker Patty Bland from Seattle, when might makes right, that's the danger. She spoke about the connection between alcohol and domestic violence, how violence, physical and mental abuse, is about control. And that's what the Tundra Women's Coalition is about. Promoting activities that encourage self-reliance, a sense of personal self-worth, and dignity. Dignity, that's the key word. In the past, a violent person was often ostracized from a village, kept away, and made to stay away. Or worse, walked out of the village by two strong men, never to be seen again. Today, in small villages and towns, it's hard to hide evidence of abuse. Yet many women do. They become ashamed of their situation and of themselves, accepting blame for their own battering. Shelters around America are educating women. In essence, teaching the family members that change is possible. What communities like Bethel, Alaska are doing is getting involved. And perhaps the most important lesson in this community is, we understand, we know your fears, we're here for you, you are not alone. Thank you, Marianne Sharp and Tundra Women's Coalition, for your help with that story. If you're watching Heartbeat Alaska right now and you're a victim of domestic violence, give us a call. No, we're not counselors, but we may have some phone numbers of people that are and can give you help and perhaps some shelter. Let's take a moment now for Claude McKenzie of Cashton's brand new music video debuting right here on Heartbeat Alaska. Claude McKenzie is a wonderful man. We interviewed him several years ago. Here he is now with Innutown. Thank you for joining us for Heartbeat Alaska Native News and Native Entertainment. I'm so happy to say that contributions are coming in for postage for our Christmas gifts that are going to the Navajo Nation and also to Pine Ridge Reservation, also to rural Alaska. Thank you so very much for helping and contributing. I'm Jeannie Green for Heartbeat Alaska. God bless you. Have a fabulous week and join us again next week. Yeah.